Hi there. Welcome to Design and Test Automation from Framework from Scratch. As a part of this discussion, we are going to cover the practical sessions on the distributed version control system, the commands that needs to be covered. As we discussed in the previous video, the agenda for this session will be as follows. They are segregated into three sets, all the commands that we wanted to play with Git. So first, we'll be working with Git everyday basic command. And then we'll be looking at Git branching and merging in the second video. And in the third video of this practical session, we'll be looking at Git collaboration and synchronization and then working with GitHub. So this is the main agenda that needs to be covered as a part of this session. So as a part of this first session, we're going to cover Git everyday basic commands. So let's fall back to our discussion. So at any point of time, assume there are two concepts over here, two lines. We fall into one of the lines. The first line is, we are already having a current version of the project that is running, and that hasn't been tracked in under the version control system. So the existing project we wanted now to be tracked under the version control system. This is one of the lines. There is a different way, there is a different line. In the second line, we are basically starting with a new project, and this new project we are assuming to be tracked under the version control system. So we'll look at each of the line how to work with. So first one, we'll see how to work with from the base, like it's a new project that has come up and we are looking at to track the project completely from the base under the version control system. So how to do that with Git bash, and also we'll be looking at how to do with Eclipse. So let's work with Git bash first. So our assumption is that we wanted to track the changes from the base of the project. So assume my directory structure of the project, that is a project base directory, is automation fm. So the basic git command that we need to use for initializing a Git repository is git init. So we need to use this command to create, to track from the base of the project for the version control system. So we use git init. So git init is used to initialize the repository in the existing directory. If we click enter, now what happens is, like, in the new repo folder, because the present working directory is e-test-automation new repo. So under this directory structure, a git repository will be created. So this is like an existing project. That is a new repository is running. So currently we are working on that. We are now there. And now we wanted to track the changes under the version control system. So that applies on the existing project. The existing project we wanted to track under version control system. At this point of time, we use git init. So let's see if you're using git init, what happens. Let's before that see whether there is anything available under any, already there is a repository, local repository maintained under new repo or not. So let's navigate to that particular folder. So it is empty. Let's refresh. It's empty. So assume new repo is the directory that has already been created. That is the project that has already been created and we are working on it. And now if we give git init command, you can see the statement over here says initialize empty git repository in this particular directory path. So under this base directory called new repo, a new local repository has been created. So let's now navigate to the repository path. You can see a git dot git. This .get is the directory of the git that views to maintain the local changes, the changes in the local system. What does this directory contains? What does this local repository contains? You can see it contains the references, the objects, and the configurations, and the heads that is being pointed to the current commit. So these are all the things that will be available as a part of local repository to track the changes of our current working project. So let's now see. So now we have covered initializing an empty Git repository. So this we are doing in two ways. So first way, for an existing project, we are adding up to the version control system, and in the second one, we are creating a new project and tracking it under version control system. So we have covered how to make the existing project being tracked under the Git repository. Now we'll be seeing how a new project will be tracked under the Git repository. So for this, assume base directory of the project will be automation fm. So for this, so I wanted to create under automation fm this repository. I want to track this automation fm project under the Git repository, so that I wanted to have this repository .git repository under that particular folder. So if you use git init automation fm, so you are here mentioning the directory, the base directory under which this repository has to be created. This local repository has to be created and tracked. So click enter. So you can see we have initialized a new repository. Over here, the difference between earlier and now is that automation fm is the base directory that was not existing, that it has been created now. And under that, the local repository to track the changes has been created. So let's navigate to the particular part. Under test automation, under new repo, automation fm and git.git. So you can see this is the main difference between git init and git init and the directory name. So we are going to track the existing project, or we are going to track the new project. So next. So we have seen how to do with git bash, that is a command line tool. Now let's see how to do it with Eclipse. Now let's create a new project. So new, I'm creating a new Maven project. Maven project, click next. Create a simple Maven project with the basic archetype, that is a Git archetype that we are going to select. So it is going to create the jar file as an artifact ID, artifact. The final output will be in the package in the form of jar. So the name of the group ID and artifact ID, I'm going to give it as Git test. Let's do it Git test. So just for understanding, we're just mentioning the Git test as an artifact ID. Click finish. Now the base directory will be created with Git test, and under that, this is the folder structure, how it will be created based on the template, that is the artifact, based on the archetype, that is Qt archetype. So this is how the folder structure will be created. Now this is the project that we wanted to track under the local repository. How to do it? click on the base directory, go to team, share project. So here you can see whether you wanted to create the local repository under your base directory structure, that is under git test, or you wanted to create in a separate location. So based on your decision, the local repository will be created, the git repository will be created under the base directory of the current project or in a different directory folder. So now let's see whether we are going to create the git repository under the base directory of the project or under a different directory. So first let's see how to create it under the base directory of the project. So as you have seen, let's have a quick recap. Right click on this, click on team, share project, and then if you select use repository, user create a repository in the parent folder of the project. This implies that this is a location where our git repository will be created. If you check this box, and this is not at all recommended, because if there is a lot of work going on, and then if you are going to commit and if you are going to track the changes and all those things, at the point of time it will take much time, and if there is any unchanged or if there is any deletions or anything of the project in the middle, so it will be some issue. So it is not always a recommended process. So project should be different at different place, and the git repository should be in a different directory. So that is always a recommended part. So let's see how to do this. Once you have done this, it says that in this location under the current base directory of the project, you are going to create repository, git repository. You can see under this current base directory of the project, you are going to create .git. So click on create repository and finish. So you can see there were some changes over here. Earlier on top, MJ used to be there. MJ is like M. M used to be there, that is, it's a Maven project. It indicates that it's a Maven project. Now you can see a cylindrical icon has been added over here. And with a greater than symbol, this implies that your symbols, these are known as label decorations, and you can see what it means from here. Navigate to Windows, Preferences, Maven, Git, which is under the label decorations. So you can see what it means to me. Each and everything has some specified naming convention. So it implies, without any greater than symbol, it implies that it was tracked. So it implies a new thing has been created and which needs to be tracked. And plus indicates it has been added to the index. Star indicates that it has been staged and it has to be committed. Symbol with a greater than symbol indicates that it is dirty. It implies that there are some changes that have been made, but they are not been staged, but has not been added through index. So that is what it implies. Since we have created in this local folder, in this base directory structure, the git local repository, that implies that there are some changes that have been done. That is, you have created a new directory, that is .git, that hadn't been tracked or staged. And we will look at all these things while working off, while working one after the other, while we are making commits and we are even going through the git status commands. At that point of time, we'll be verifying these label decorations. Okay, now click cancel. So you can see earlier it used to have git test. Now we have git test, and under brackets, you can see git test master. This will be added as a part of the head. So this is the branch which we have, and this is the default branch that we will be available with. So now let's see How to open the repository view? Right click. So now let's see what is the working directory and what is the current branch and all those things. So once it has been done, once we have created a local repository, Git repository in this working directory, right click and go to properties and click on Git. And over here you will be able to see what is the Git directory, where is the path of this Git directory. It is under the current base directory structure of the project. And then what is the working tree? The working tree path is this one. And then the branch currently is master. So none, empty repository, nothing has been tracked. So close it. Now how to see the repository view? Right click, team. So now we have connected to the repository. So click on show and repository view. So you can see Git test master, so it is on the master branch. So there are no local branches, there are no remote branches. So what is the local branch and the remote branch? Local branch are like, it is going to track the local changes from the working directory to the Git local repository. Remote tracking branch are used for push and pull purpose. That is, you are configuring the remote branch URL for pushing and the remote branch URL for pulling the project to. So it is used for tracking the synchronization between our local Git repository to the central GitHub repository server. And local branch is used for tracking the synchronization between our working directory to the local Git repository. And tags we'll be discussing a bit later. So tags are nothing but like, it is used for tracking the version. So assume version 1.0 we have released, and we are currently under version 2.0 and 3.0. And we wanted to see what are the changes, what are the things that have been as a part of version 1.0. Or we wanted to check back to the version 1.0 and we wanted to work from there for some particular client. So we can use the git tag command so that we can get the changes on that particular version and we can start working from there. So git remotes. So Git remote tracking branches are used for making the changes in the local branch, and then we are going to push it to the central repository. And Git remotes are used for configuring the push and pull. So you can see, if you right click on this, you can see create remote. When you click on is remote branch name and origin, remote name origin, and what is the thing you wanted to do? You want to configure remote push or configure fetch. So you need to configure the URLs, which we'll be discussing once we have in the third part of the video, that is the synchronization part. Close it, and the working tree, you can see. We have been tracking the Git repository under the working tree. So this should not be the case as we have been already discussing. See, this is not the recommended process. So now let's delete, let's disconnect. I'll just leave this one alone as it is, and let's create one more project. New Maven project. Click next. So just click finish. So now we are going to create one more project to understand how to create the project, to understand how to create a local repository, Git repository, in a different folder structure or different directory, not in the working directory of the current project. Team, share project. Once it was done, don't check on this one. Click on create and then click on browse. And assume I wanted to create over here under APM. Oh, let's go over here. create a new directory. Git practical and click on select folder. Select this folder. Slash. We want to create the directory as new repository. And click on finish. You can see now the working tree will be tracked under new repository, and we will be getting our target location for the Git will be here, and the current location of the project will be under Git test 2, and our target location for the project is different from the target location where we are going to maintain the Git repository. Now click on finish. Before that, it has already been created. Since we click on create, so you can see new repository dot git. So just let us navigate to the particular folder structure so that we can see. So you can see git practical, and under that new repository has been created, and this is the folder. So local git repository has been created using this. So now our current working directory, our current project structure is under the workspace, there is git test 2, Eclipse workspace, git test 2, and our target, that is the target location where our git repository was available, is different location. So this is what needs to be ensured. Click on finish, and you can see new repository, this folder, and under that is the master branch. So you can see with question mark and greater than symbol implies that the changes were in the current directory, but it has not been tracked to our local repository. So guys, now we have seen how to create a new repository, Git repository, using Eclipse, and also we have seen how to create a new repository using the Git Bash, that is command line version of the Git client.